24:6, A Prescription for a Healthier, Happier Life. Written by Matthew Sleeth. Narrated by Clayton Butcher. Forward. The subject of Sabbath keeping is in the air these days. I think I have read with admiration and appreciation most of the books and articles written on this subject in the last 50 years. Maybe you have too. No matter. You must read this latest entry in the genre. Matthew Sleeth has crafted a compelling invitation to consider and participate in Sabbath keeping, an invitation that is, in my experience, without peer. His credentials are impressive. His years of experience as an ER physician in hospitals qualifies him as a veteran in a culture of demanding overwork. His entry into the Christian faith 10 years ago provides a total reorientation of his imagination in the Hebrew Christian culture of Sabbath keeping. And most impressive of all, he explores the many details of what is involved in practicing Sabbath in a world that is unrelenting in its distractions and pressures to work longer and harder. He does it not as an impersonal expert, but firmly in the context of marriage and family, with all the domestic and relational details involved in doing nothing, where doing nothing always requires constant coordination and relationship. Under Dr. Sleeth's pen, Sabbath, a dead word for so many, undergoes a resurrection, comes alive, not as a bare commandment, the fourth in the sequence of 10, but as a vigorous way to live in the present. This takes place in a freshly imagined, but not fanciful, recovery of the salvation and Jesus context of the Scriptures. The writer's mastery of the entire biblical revelation raises Sabbath keeping far above an unadorned rule to be kept. In detail after detail, it comes to be seen as a cornerstone for comprehending a world defined in all its daily living by God's rest, God's not doing. He showcases Jesus' recovery of Sabbath keeping unfettered by the legalistic restrictions that had taken all the creativity and joy out of Sabbath in the world in which Jesus grew up. Jesus is still the primary antidote to the cheerless rule-keeping associated with Sabbath in our time. Which is to say that this is a book that restores Sabbath to its extensive biblical narrative context. Jesus, not rules, sets the tone. This Sabbath keeping is conveyed in stories. Doctor stories, stories of friends, stories of family, Jesus stories. The stories keep Sabbath nested, integral to the time and place in which relationships form and develop. Everything is written in ways that give men and women dignity and room, atmosphere and space to be themselves in a good creation. There's not a hint of judgmentalism against any who are either unaware of or hostile to this holy day. Sabbath is simply presented not as a rule to be kept, but as a freedom to enter into. Not the least of the attractions of 24:6 is the style of the writing. With wit, sharply observed phrasings, new ways to express old truths. Dr. Sleeth renames Sabbath Stop Day. And here are a few sentences that stopped me in my tracks. If the Ten Commandments are written on apple pie and you get to choose which slice to have based upon size, choose the fourth. You will get more than a third of the pie put on your plate. No one ever found the Lord on the day they won the lottery. Faith is more likely to blossom on the day we lose our job. Stopping and resting are the working definitions of holy. The seventh day is blessed as holy because the Lord stopped and rested. And here's a meditative practice that I find attractive. Until now, I'd never come across subtracting one word at a time from Psalm 46:10 to help me come to rest. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am. Be still and know that I. Be still and know that. Be still and know. Be still and. Be still. B. The cumulative effect on me of this extended, comprehensive...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.